Hello, welcome back. You're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Dorian Gonsalves. He's the CEO of Belvoir Group. Dorian, good to speak with you today. So you reported a very strong first half as you recovered from trading restrictions that impacted you last year. Even compared to 2019, it's been a significant improvement. Take us through those first half financials because they were ahead of market expectations.
Yeah, sure. As you're right, Sammy, we operate in sort of three main sectors. So property sales, property lettings, which is the sort of strong recurring underlying revenue element of the business. When we first floated back in 2012, we were just a residential lettings business, and we've sort of expanded and diversified over the last sort of 5 or 6 years into mortgages and also estate agency as well. So just to give you an idea of the metrics, the sort of gains since this time last year. So comparing H1 this year against H1 last year, estate agency revenue is up 78%, which in some ways you would expect because the market has been very, very active on house sales, partially due to a stamp duty holiday, which comes to an end at the end of September. But actually our sales pipeline, so our pipeline on estate agency is 70% bigger in August this year compared with August 2019, which is actually just a strong illustration that a lot of the activity in the house sales market isn't only related to the stamp duty holiday, because let's face it, property prices have gone up primarily as a result of the stamp duty holiday. Therefore, people aren't actually benefiting. People who sort of joined the rush late in the day aren't really benefiting from the stamp duty holiday because they're paying more for a property. And our pipelines are 70% larger than in 2019, even with the stamp duty holiday coming to an end. So it just shows that, you know, people are moving house for lots of other reasons, not just the stamp duty holiday, which is about to come to an end. And because it takes sort of 4 months, 5 months for a property to complete, the visibility of our pipelines is really important to us because we can now see where we're likely to end up in the final quarter of the year. And we are confident that we will meet market expectations in the full year. So I appreciate today we're talking about our half year, but as I said, we are confident we will achieve market expectations in the full year, primarily because we do have visibility of what our quarter four might look like.
Dorian, are you surprised at how buoyant the property market has been, just given the impact of COVID-19 last year? Of course, we had Brexit and all sorts of other factors. Are you surprised that the market's held up so well?
Yeah, I think there are lots of factors for that. I mean, you know, a few of the factors are access to cheap mortgages. Yesterday I was looking at some of the mortgage deals that are available, and there are lots of mortgage deals out there for a 5-year period, less than 1% as far as the rates are concerned. So this is really cheap borrowing. So cheap borrowing sort of underpins the market. But then on top of that, what we have seen is a behavioural change. You know, people looking, although I appreciate it, you know, it's somewhat of a cliche word, but, you know, the race for space is quite often talked about with housing, and that's especially over the last few months. And that's mainly where people are just looking to move house because they want more space to do their gardening or spend time outside or to work from home. So I think what COVID has done is it sort of it's really pushed people into, if people were thinking about moving house because they wanted more space, it's given them a cast iron reason to move house, within this period. And a lot of people have tried to take advantage of the stamp duty holiday, and why not? And some people have taken advantage of that, and some people still have sales that are ongoing that will complete before the end of the year. But that's just outside of the stamp duty window.
You talked about cheap mortgages. Any concern that once interest rates start rising, that'll dampen the market a bit?
I mean, I think there isn't really any sign of interest rates going up in the short term. And, you know, almost the opposite, really. We're seeing mortgage lenders are so very competitive that they're offering long-term fixed term deals at very, very competitive rates. Now, we've sort of grown our mortgage business quite aggressively over the last 3 years. So in H1 last year, we finished H1 with 174 mortgage advisors underneath our umbrella. That number now is 242. So we've had 46 advisors join us over the last 12 months. And in addition to that, we acquired a mortgage business in July this year, which brought on 21 more advisors and 6 support staff. So what I'm coming to is that, you know, if estate agency transactions do return to normal, I suspect that what we will see in the last quarter of this year is more activity on the remortgage side of the business. So, you know, rates being very attractive, clients who may be coming to the end of their fixed term or to secure one of these really competitive deals.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned the acquisition, and you ended the period with very strong cash generation, net debt, £4 million. So that was down, and that was despite the acquisitions. So, I mean, cash generation has been very good.
It certainly has. And what we've done sort of, you know, in response to that, so we have increased our dividend. So we've increased our dividend by 17.6% from 3.4 pence to 4p per share for the first half, just for the first half. And I'm sure that will go down very well with our investors. On top of that, we are very keen on future acquisitions. So we've acquired 8 businesses. So since 2015, we've acquired 8 sort of corporate acquisitions, such as the Lavelle business and the Humphreys business that we bought earlier this year, and Newton Fallowell and Northwood, much bigger businesses that we acquired sort of 2 and 3 years ago. So we are very acquisitive. And then on top of that, we've helped our franchisees to acquire 105 businesses over the last 5 years. That's really where a franchisee buys one of their competitors and we help them operationally and financially. So we are very acquisitive. And I think it's fair to say that, you know, the next sort of 3 to 4 months, as our market starts to return to normal, I think that that will present more acquisition opportunities that we're keen to make the most of.
And I'm sure you'll tell us all about them. Maybe just ending off with the outlook for the second half of the year. You mentioned that dividend up 17.6%. How are the second 6 months shaping up so far?
Yes, I mean, with the second half of the year, I mean, I did say earlier that we're confident that we'll achieve market expectations in the full year. Pipelines are still very strong on estate agency and financial services. And interestingly, there is a lot of activity on the letting side of the business. Year on year, we're 21% up in terms of lettings revenue. So, you know, the demand for rental properties is very strong. Rents are going up in all regions of the UK. So when I reported to the market in April, I said that pretty much rents were going up everywhere apart from in London. Rents are now going up in London as well. And some areas of the UK are seeing double-digit growth, such as the East Midlands, the South West. South West tops the tree at sort of 11 to 12%. Rental growth, East Midlands, sort of 10.5% increases on new rents being achieved. So we're just seeing activity on all fronts.
That's Dorian Gonsalves. He's the CEO of Belvoir Group.